Come on, Roach.
Defeatism and desertion.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, Roach.
Oh!
What is that?
Take it easy.
I saw you in Vizier.
Slow now. Whoa.
Used to be wagons showed on market days, loaded with all kinds of fat, smoked bacon, lard.
See, you're a man well travelled, so tell me. You beat me when you want to speak.
All you can trade is what little hope's left.
Good ladies, they say. Merciful ladies.
my guardian and protector. I thank you, I do.
See what you're offering. So long.
So, you want a pre-made?
What would you say to a little game of Gwent?
So, you want a pre-made, or have you got a special order?
Could you make a breastplate if I provided a master's diagram?
Nah, nor could anyone else here. Except for... what was his...
Except for who?
There was one fellow. Fergus, a dwarf. Worked for me for a while, with an apprentice, a lass.
Know what became of him?
They were good at what they did, so they moved on to Crow's Perch. Baron. His men need smithing all the time. No lack of work there.
So long.
can't lose hope.
Know the price for their help. Blood, their nightmares.
Wanna try some goose foot? It's supposed to taste like beans.
Damn, sits in the old oak tree. Grew inside.
Let's go!
Don't you look at me!
Hey-ya! Slower.
Yourself.
your skin off.
Don't let him catch his breath!
With vigor, lads! Vigor!
Casting curses!
Given me no choice.
Thank you.
Take it easy.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell. Giddy up. Slower.
So, you want a pre-made?
So long.
Come on, Roach. That's it, Roach. Run, Roach. Not so fast, Roach. That's it, Roach.
There's some more on our bike.
You!
Faster. By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Dea. Lead me to those bound to you by blood. Faster.
Drinks enough for a whole platoon since his family. Serves a job, child.
Fox on the love of you.
Help!
Wizardry! Let me live.
What did I do to deserve your company?
What now? Sure wasn't lavender they kept in there. Might be worth looking around, though. Horseshoe. No way a pitch burner could afford a horse. A bracelet. One of them must have dropped it. Clothing. They change in here. Both were here. I'm going the right way. Wants to show me something more. Go, go. Come on. Examine that horse carcass. What do we have here? Bones have been here a while. Chewed on the saddle. Necrophages will eat anything these days. Giant claws. Wasn't a necrophage made these marks. Horseshoes missing. Is this the animal that lost one in the smokehouse? Head torn clear off. Takes incredible strength. Must have been attacked by a powerful beast. Surprised him. Hope they got away. Trail goes on. Good thing it doesn't end here. Hey there. A fisherman's hut. Seems she wants me to take a closer look.
Seek here, sir. Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure? not even passing through. Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
That sir came at night, right, Mummy?
Quiet, boy!
I want to help that woman. She could be in danger.
Young and see no one, my lord. He's a kiddie. Must have dreamt it.
I want to hear this dream then. So, kid, who did you see? Who came here?
Pappy brought her at night, the lady does the medicines. She was all afeard. Talked about an awful monster, said she had to go back, don't know where to. Mummy and Pappy cheered her up, gave her clothes. Hers were ragged.
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough. No point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir, but you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is, hoy. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Anna, that's another tale.
Though anywhere's better than to crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I mean. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
Twere like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of you. Moon had arisen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we set off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. 'Twere then I saw it. Fiery marks on her hands.
What marks?
These, well, like burned on with hot iron. On the palms, inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. These hot and glowing, as if they burned with raw fire.
Fine, what happened next?
Grew even darker. Seems someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden, and then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat, and before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'was the only reason we escaped. The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I'd a debt. Owed Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara alerted, brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me a time of war and contempt's come, a time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman.
Crying shame we couldn't save Mrs. Anna in the end.
Thanks for your help.
The lady, she'll be all right in the end, won't she?
I'll do what I can to see that she is.
We're simple folk. We seek no quarrel.
So here our paths diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace.
Come on, Roach.
Ask a service of the Witcher, the Pelamost. A witcherly service, that's to say.
What do you need? Tell me.
A man who fears no evil, the Pella needs. Forefather's Eve is nigh. We've rites to conduct. Wandering souls to emerge, damned souls too. We've the circle to protect from these wretches.
What'll I get out of it?
Witches do naught for free, this the Pella knows. Not to fear. how to reward one for their aid. This too the Pella knows.
Why hold the ritual at all?
At times men die choking with regret. At times death takes them before they've tasted any bitterness in life. These poor souls, unfulfilled, cannot leave this vale of tears. Their spirits wander midst the living, must be judged, sent on their way. This we do on Forefathers' Eve.
Seems like you could use a witcher, so yeah, I'll help.
You'd not refuse, the Pella knew. The time's come to gather the folk. Across the lake we must journey, to Fyke Isle. There in the circle of stones we shall meet.
The sooner we resolve this, the better. Best do it tonight at midnight.
Remember me?
Stablehand pulled you out of the fire.
We'll never forget that. Here, I'm grateful.
Rubble everywhere.
What do you seek here, vagrants?
Whoa!
Oh!
Rubble. Rubble everywhere.
Witcher. A word, please.
What is it?
That night, when the Baron ordered everyone to lock their doors, stay inside. What did you and the Baron do?
Gotta ask the Baron about that. Speaking of which, know where he is?
Garden. Spends a lot of time sitting there of late.
Drunk?
No. Don't drink, don't eat. Just sit.
There you are.
See the hollyhock there? The violet blooms. Brought the plants here from Nazaire. Anna had read some story. Insisted on having them. Spent hours tending to them, trimming, pruning. She was so content at that. And them, the frilly ones, called birds of paradise in Zerikania. But Tamara called them dragons of paradise. She adored them. Damn shame I'll never learn which blooms would please Dea most. Though it's good to know her spirit's free.
Your loss, it must hurt bad. But there wasn't anything we could do.
No, not now, not anymore. It was too late, that was clear. Should have acted earlier. Taken them all from this damned felon. In this hole. This reasty mire. Nothing could go right here.
Got some information about your family.
You've learned something? Well, let's go inside. It's a bit chilly out. Any news for me?
Your daughter's in Oxenfurt.
What the blazes? She all right? In good health? Safe? Why haven't you brought her back?
Never offered to do that,
How do you know she's safe? You see her at least?
No, but I talked to the man who helped her escape and then took her in. Tamara is safe and sound. From what I gathered, she has no desire to see you again, no intention to return.
I shan't trust some peasant dolt. I shan't trust whoever it has helped her. I need to know for certain she's safe. Go to her. You must be sure. See her yourself. I shan't believe anyone else.
That much I can do.
I'm grateful. Take this, call it enticement, and this might prove useful.
What is it?
A letter of safe conduct. Ever since the Redanians took hold of the Pontar Delta, they made it damned hard to get to Novigrad without one. Very well. You were to find them both. What have Anna learned anything?
Nothing yet, but I'm on her trail.
Well, what are you waiting for?
For you to tell me about Ciri, like we agreed.
Fine. A word once given. When Ciri was on the mend, we took her out on a hunt. Thought a bit of galloping would warm up her limbs gone stiff from so much bed rest. That lass of yours, pure luck in the flesh. To hunt down a wild boar that size, why, worthy of one of King Faltest's feasts, were he still among the living. Ciri, come! Our haunt should be yours as I see it.
Aye, you're done well, lass.
Not bad. Not bad at all. But who goes boar hunting with a sword?
No bow at hand, no spear. My sword was all I had.
Well, you brandished it beautifully. Where'd they teach you that, anyway?
At Kaer Morhen.
Witcher school there, aye. But they only took lads, as I recall.
They made an exception for me.
Right. Mean to say you're a she-witcher?
Not entirely. The mutations, I was never subjected to them. But everything else I know, I learned from the witchers there.
Know any of them potions?
Not so much. A bit.
Because you see, at times I get this pinching back here.
Shut it, Ygrin. Nobody cares about your backside. A woman could swing a sword. I've knowed one. But never seen a lady mount anything but a cock proper. All tipsy on horseback. Nothing strange on account they bloody mount them sideways.
Perhaps you'd care to wager?
Think you can outrun me on an horse? Naturally. What's the stake?
Black mare. The one in the stable.
Oh, that won't do at all.
Well, that's an awfully gloomy face. Too much of a coward to race a woman.
The horse is mine.
To race the Baron himself, I'd consider it an honor.
Oh, that'd be a sight to behold.
Would it ever?
Done. But if I win, I take your sword.
Agreed.
I'd not drink any more this night. You'll want your head about you. We start at daybreak.
Day dawns.
Ready?
As ever. First one to the tower.
Man chop! Come on, Ciri, don't you embarrass us!
Your sword is mine!
That'll be the day!
Kick it!
sure how it's done!
You're wind, not woman. Worthy of the best horse. The mare is yours.
Thank you.
What?
Another chance to win.
She screamed like a mad woman. In an instant, all had forgotten the wager. Every man ran to save his skin, even were it to break his neck.
And they make it?
Some, aye. Others were not so fortunate. But what happened then? I must say, Witcher, seen a lot, but nothing like this. Never.
Uh-oh. I know that look.
You're a fast learner. You'll know the rest once you find my wife.
Working on it.
And making piss-poor progress.
They split up. Hadn't considered that possibility before. But don't worry. I'll find Anna, too. So long.